So you want to be able to make full-time trading work, but you're not sure what style to use and how to use that style for best results. Well, in this video that's going to change, we'll give you a comprehensive process on how to do that. Whatever style you pick, how to make it work. What's up, traders? Welcome back to Montreal in Canada. I'm here for some time and I'll be getting back to Asia pretty soon. But today I want to share with you a kind of different video. So this is a series of videos I'm starting out that's going to be sponsored by a broker for the first time. I decided to partner with Pepperstone this time to bring you something more powerful, to bring you something that can help you out in your trading and something that is going to go beyond what I'm able to teach myself. So in this video, I want to cover with you basically trading styles. We'll talk about discretionary versus systematic trading, which one to pick, which one's going to be the best for you, and how to go about succeeding with each of them. And I'll have a special guest from Pepperstone to explain some topics in detail for you to be able to get 10 times the value you get on a typical video of mine. So first things first, I want to explain to you guys a little bit about discretionary versus systematic trading. And I think it's important to define because people have different definitions of that. They see things differently. And until you understand what each is about and what it's not about, it's going to be really hard to succeed. So discretionary trading first. My view of this concept is discretionary trading is about having a plan in trading, like everyone should have a plan. But you have the ability to modify your plan or to take or not take trades based on the circumstances that happen in the market in real time. So you might see a trade set up in the market. You say, well, that's a good trade based on my plan, but I won't enter it. Or you see a trade that doesn't quite fit your style, your strategy, but you say, well, I'll enter it. I'll enter that trade because I think it's a good trade. Okay, and that's based, of course, on experience, not just a feeling, but on experience and a real understanding of the market. Okay, that's the first thing. Now, on the other side, I believe that traders that are systematic are traders that trade based on a predefined system and or a set of rules that they follow all the time. And they follow them no matter what. So you might have this process you wrote down, and then you just follow that process all the time, no matter what. Good trade, bad trade, doesn't matter. You just follow the process, whether you win or lose, and that's it. Okay, you don't care about anything else outside. You don't modify your plan. You don't trade or not trade based on your feelings. You keep doing the same thing all the time. Okay. Now, of course, with this being said, these are kind of like the extremes, so discretionary or systematic trading, but you can have a mix of both. I believe my trading style right now, the style that I trade all the time, is a little bit of a mix of both. So I might be in a place where I have a setup that's perfect in the market, but I say, well, based on the market now, based on the volatility or the volumes or whatever, I'm not going to trade. I'm going to skip this trade because that doesn't make sense. Like the place in which I would take the trade, it's not a good place to take a trade. So I would not take the trade, I would skip the trade. Or I might say, well, here the market's too messy, so I won't trade. Even though the setup appears, or it might appear, I won't trade. That's kind of a more discretionary style. But my system, my setup, the rules that I have for taking trades are very predefined. They're very fixed, and they're very simple to understand, okay? So you can have a mix of both. Don't think it's like one world or the other. It's like, it can be both, okay? It can be a little bit of both. And I think that's the best way to do it. But then the question that comes is, how do you actually pick your style? Do you go with like a mix of both? Do you go with only one or two? And I believe this depends on three things. First of all, your personality. So for example, if you are very impulsive, you might be better with a more discretionary style because you might be kind of more tempted to modify your trades or something. Or if you are someone that's going to be more kind of creative, artistic, then again, discretionary might be better. But if you're someone more analytical, more kind of down to earth, then systematic might be better, okay? And of course, you can have a mix of both. The second thing to look at is going to be your lifestyle. So what do you do in your life? Do you kind of go to work and then you have to do this and that and you have other things and you don't have time to look at the market? Or maybe you have like all the time in your life to kind of trade and look at the market and read stuff and analyze the market. That could be the case. That could not be the case. It depends. And then what is your personal interest? What do you prefer as a person to do? Do you prefer it to be discretionary or systematic? Yeah. And I go with the same thing for your trading style. If you're going to be, let's say, a scalper, a day trader, a swing trader, or a position trader. Okay, that is also the same factors that will influence what you do overall. Okay, but just think about these things. And now comes the point where I want to introduce you guys to Chris Weston. Chris is working at Pepperstone as investment manager. He's been here before on the channel, sharing about his trading and things that he looks at in the market. And I want to bring him here on the video to be able to kind of explain more in depth how to succeed in both cases, as a discretionary or a systematic trader. So first, here's a bit of background about Chris.
Yeah, my name is Chris Weston. I head up the research team here at Pepperstone. My job really is to put out interesting research, compelling research, talking about how markets may react, but also, you know, I think for people who are looking to analyse risk and risk events, we put out fairly holistic views around how various events may affect markets. And of course, that's really important whether you're a technical trader or a fundamental trader to understand the risks that are coming through the markets and adapt to them.
And now, here's what he had to say about succeeding as a discretionary trader.
Well, I don't think there's any difference between systematic and discretionary in the ultimate objective for trading, and that is to grow the capital in your account and to manage risks accordingly. You need a trading plan and a process to achieve that. And what does that look like? Whether you're making your own judgment or whether you've got a back-tested strategy which has given you what is effectively what's needed here, an edge. How do you go about finding your edge, whether you're making your own judgments or whether you're letting a system execute that process for you? I mean, that's up to you. But how you can control your emotions when you're a discretionary trader is something that you all need to happen, because that's really where you fall into this pitfall of taking your profits too early. You're getting emotional because the, you know, volatility kicks up and you're worried that you're going to see a rollover in the position, and you know, people then obviously holding on to those losses too long, and in that situation a systematic approach would probably be somewhat better. If you can control your emotions as part of a trading process, how you go about adapting, choosing which asset class to trade, which, you know, what trade, where your entry points, why you've chosen that, you know, I think that's ultimately that's for you to find. But in both situations, whether you're trading discretionary or you're using a system and letting a system actually execute the orders on your behalf, you need to find an edge and a process that you can adhere to, and adhering to that process going on long term. So it can be more cumbersome doing that as a discretionary trader, because you're so much more exposed to market forces and emotion. But you know, there's a lot of people who do this very well, and I think people who are discretionary will tend to take a really clear view and have a very strong interest in what's going to happen with markets, what's going to happen with the Fed, what's Donald Trump going to say, how could that move markets, and then you choose the right vehicle and the position sizing and various factors around that. But people who tend to trade discretionary have a more active approach and a more interest in financial markets and how they may trade. I think that's the situation, but of course the negative is that they have to control their emotion and control their discipline, and that can be quite hard to do.
Now, you got to keep in mind that systems trader also have their challenges. One of them is they might come up with a system that's too rigid, too many rules, too many factors, too many things to look at, or it's just too strict that they cannot take enough trade, or the system is too hard to execute, and that's something that happened. And a good piece of advice to be able to succeed as a systems trader is to make an effort to adapt and change over time.
Well, we're always tweaking, we're always optimizing, aren't we? I mean, that's the situation, is that you can never be happy. You're always trying to tweak performance. And I think one of the things that we see a lot of the time in the difference between systematic and discretionary is that, you know, in discretionary, you'll tend to see people, you know, being a master of a jack of all trades and a master of none. And they will, you know, try and look at far too many assets. And we see a lot of people in the systematic world really honing in on maybe two or three markets and working out what is the best strategy for trading those markets. What's the most optimized strategy to tweak out the best performance? When you're back testing a strategy, we tend to start with two or three currency pairs or an index, for example, work out what is the best way to and the most profitable strategy that gives you the best positive expectancy in that market, and continue with there. Of course, you know, your sample size is very key, and you know, the longer you're going to you back test over multiple cycles, the higher your positive expectancy is going to be. But I think that's the big issue, is that when you're starting out in systematic land, you'll tend to see one or two currency pairs that you'll get very familiar with. You'll tweak and you'll hone your strategies around that, and you'll try and always kind of tweak a little bit here to try and get the best performance out of that over the cycle. You know, you might be looking at a 20-day moving average crossing over a 50 at a very simplistic stage, and then you decide to sort of tamper with the time frames around that, tamper with your moving averages, add another indicator until you're trying to get the best situation. But of course, you know, we're always trying to tamper and optimize the performance and the drawdown and various factors that comes in your EA strategy. A lot of people who have been quite successful in the systematic world will actually buy an off-the-shelf expert advisor that they've seen and they understand the logic that's behind that, and then they may actually come and tweak that in themselves. And I think we've seen people who have been very successful in that situation who have bought an EA and they actually tweak the performance and actually try to get a bit more out of that. The other issue that I think is really important for people who are starting out on in their systematic journey and using expert advisors is that people need to remember that, you know, the markets change, the EA doesn't. It does what it's told to do. It's not artificial intelligence. If you program the expert advisor to execute a specific strategy, it's going to do exactly that. And the number one thing that we always see why people end up, you know, they might do well at one stage and then they might do poorly, is that the market conditions change. Your expert advisor may work really, really well in a low volatility environment. You might be doing mean reversion, for example, and then volatility kicks up and, you know, you see that range expansion and there probably hasn't been a sort of inbuilt calculation for adapting to volatility within the expert advisor, and then suddenly the market change and your expert advisor doesn't do so well. So I think having an understanding of the backdrop by which your expert advisor works in is really important as well. And that's one of the things that I sort of try and teach clients is, you know, while you might not have a good understanding or even a real interest in the fundamentals of what's going on in the market, if we can anticipate a higher volatility environment or a higher change in the market conditions, which may or may not suit your expert advisor, that can be really beneficial as well. And you can take a discretionary approach to systematic trading where you say to yourself, well, the market conditions just don't warrant don't favor my expert advisor at the moment. And in that situation, you may look to, you know, lower the position size or even actually turn the expert advisor off for a period of time. Well, there's an element of crossover for sure. But I think ultimately, what we've got to learn as discretionary traders is how we can manage emotion, you know, like a robot, like a system in a way. Because, you know, the best thing we can do is let our profits run and take our losses early. I mean, that sounds so simplistic. You probably heard it a million times from every educator out there. But, you know, actually doing that in principle is just incredibly difficult to do. That's why a system works really well. You know, it just does it for you. You know, you continue to hold your discipline. The robot has all the discipline. You can backtest the strategy and see if you have an edge. And then you can execute effectively. Now, if you can do those same principles as a discretionary trader, you know, you can do very well in that situation. But we always see that the reason why discretionary traders, their system always falls apart is because, you know, they get overblown by emotion and market forces. If you can have a systematic approach to your discretionary trading, then, you know, obviously that you can really hone in on your edge in that situation.
I think in the end, what it comes down to is making a process, no matter what your style. Whatever you do in the market, whatever your style is, have a plan, have a process. A plan will save you from mistakes that you could be avoiding easily. It will also ensure that you have results that are consistent over time. You don't want to be up and down all the time. You don't want to be kind of having to worry about your income or your result in the market. You want to make trading something that's consistent, that will give you results that are predictable or fairly predictable over time. And I think that's the big goal. You can only achieve this with a plan. Without a plan, it's going to be hard to do. Or without the process, it's going to be even harder to do. So the question that comes now is, how do you go about creating that process?
Well, the process is defined by you as an individual. What I have as a process and a plan will be very different from everyone else. I mean, your process is driven by your lifestyle, your personality, your situation, how much time you can be in the market, how often you can be in front of your screens.
So that's it. I think Chris was pretty right in that. And I want to thank him once again for being here on the video. I think having more people from other kind of parts of the world, other backgrounds, other companies even help kind of make the channel better, help you guys get more results. So leave me your thoughts below in the comment. I appreciate you guys for being here as always. Here's the featured comments in the past video. Appreciate you guys always for leaving comments in the comment section. And I want to finish up with a quick word about Pepperstone. So as you guys know, I have been trying out a lot of brokers in the past. Some are good, some are bad, some I recommend, some I don't. I think Pepperstone is a place where you can surround yourself with the right people and you can learn from people that are much better than you or I am, and that's a good thing. So if you want to be able to kind of get an account with them and stuff, just check out the link below in the comment section. Link to me on the screen as well, is archer.com/Pepperstone. They will offer you a good deal, I'm sure. and you'll be able to see the details on that page that's going to be linked below. And with that being said, I'll catch you guys back in the next video. Ciao.